Before beginning with the video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to stay updated of my latest videos. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint. In this video, I will be discussing with you 8 different ways to crop an image in PowerPoint. Crop tool is widely used technique to trim the unnecessary parts of the image. However, many people use professional softwares like Adobe Photoshop to crop an image like this. But very few people know that the same crop tool is available in Microsoft PowerPoint itself, which allows us to crop an image in 8 different ways. Guys, do watch this video till the end because I will be sharing very useful tips and tricks. And there is also a bonus tip for you all at the end of this video. Moreover, after learning all these cropping techniques, you will be able to create advanced level animation effects using the crop tool like this, and the video for the same has already been uploaded on my channel. You can find the link for the same in the YouTube show notes below. So without wasting any more time, let's get started with the tutorial. The first method is the simple crop tool, which most of you would be familiar with. Simply insert your image, go to the picture format tab, hit the crop tool there, and then crop the unnecessary parts of the image. As simple as that. Now, where most of the PowerPoint users know how to use this simple crop tool, there are very few people who bother to click on this drop down arrow button, which is placed just below the crop tool. And here comes our next cropping technique, which is crop to shape. When I click on this option, I can choose from various shapes available and the image will be cropped in that particular shape only. Let me show you that. Isn't it beautiful? The third cropping technique is based upon the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio is the ratio between the width and the height of the image. Like for this image, I want to fit this image completely in the slide and make its aspect ratio in direct proportion to that of the PowerPoint slide. So I will select the image, again go to that drop-down menu below the crop tool and click on the aspect ratio. Here, 1:1 aspect ratio refers to a square, but I will go for the ratio of 16:9, which is the default aspect ratio of a PowerPoint slide. You can see that the image gets cropped automatically, and as I drag its corner points, it fits in the slide completely without any efforts. So this saves a lot of time and energy. The next cropping tool is really an interesting one. Insert your image in the slide, go to the Home tab, and here you will find the Scribble tool. Select the Scribble tool and start drawing roughly along the subject. When you're done, select the image first, and then while holding the shift key, select the scribble drawn. Guys, I have used this technique in my other videos as well, and I would repeat for you all that you need to take care that the order of selection should be like this only. First the image and then the scribble drawn. Now go to the shapes format tab, then click on merge shapes and select intersect. Now to make it look cleaner, right click the image and select format picture. Select the soft edges and increase its size. You can also add a shadow and play with its properties like this. And here is the final outcome. The next cropping technique is also an interesting one, which is the Remove Background technique. Insert your image in the slide. Go to the Picture Format tab and the very first option says Remove Background. Select this option and PowerPoint automatically tries to remove the background from the image. However, to make it look perfect, you need to mark the areas to keep and mark the areas to remove, as I am doing with this image. So now you no longer need professional softwares like Adobe Photoshop to remove the background from your images. The next technique is the Merge Intersect method. Insert your image in the slide. Go to the Insert tab and insert the desired shape in which you want to crop your image. Place the shape over the image. Now select the image first and then while holding the Shift key, select the inserted shape. Go to the Shapes Format tab, click on Merge Shapes and select Intersect. Guys, did you notice that as soon as I open a new PowerPoint slide, PowerPoint offers me various design ideas on the right side to choose from. And as soon as I insert an image in the slide, these design ideas include that image in them as well, and they automatically crop the image in various shapes and styles. You can choose the one which matches best to your picture. The final cropping technique is by using the Smart Art. This is extremely useful to simultaneously crop and arrange more than one image in your slide. Select all your images in the slide, go to the Picture Format tab and here click on Picture Layout. Choose from amongst the various options available and your image gets cropped and arranged in a beautiful manner in no time. There is another bonus tip for all you guys, which is that you can also save your cropped picture in your system. To save a cropped image, right click the cropped picture and select Save Picture As. Guys, do remember that you need to save the image in the PNG format so as to retain its transparent background property. Also, you can apply these cropping techniques and create wonderful animation effects. I have already uploaded a separate video for this in which I have made various advanced level animation effects using all these cropping techniques, and the video has already been uploaded on my channel and the link for the same will be shared in the YouTube show notes below. Do check out that video. So that's it guys. I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.